There's obviously a lot to talk about in the Republican race, and it's not just about, and this is one of the things I want to make clear on why what we're seeing is so important, more important, I think, than what we saw in 2012 in terms of the actual dynamic in the race. It's not just about the horse race. It is about the Republican Party's veneer being ripped apart. It is about their infrastructure being, in many ways, twisted and destroyed. We're going to talk about that later. And it's also about the Republican candidates following Donald Trump down a wormhole that's going to make it impossible for them to come out and see the light of day when it comes time to run in the general election, regardless of who that's against. But let's start with Donald Trump's first major foray, I guess, into introducing a policy. And what is stunning, in addition to the policy, and I know you've got a lot to say on that, Farron, is that we are 2 months out from Donald Trump's, I believe it was, his announcement. And the Republican race is still dominated by three sentences he said in that announcement about immigration. It just shows the sort of the power that Donald Trump has in that hermetically sealed world.
You know, that is remarkable when you put it in those terms, the fact that it was those few words that he spoke that laid out his entire campaign, and he's still riding that wave, and unfortunately that wave is only getting bigger.
Not just his wave, right? I mean, his campaign, it defined the campaigns. None of those other Republican right. candidates wanted to go into this leading with their incredibly nativist views on immigration. That is not what their game plan was, I can assure you.
Right. You know, Trump throws out these talking points in this, you know, announcement speech, and suddenly that became the cornerstone of the entire Republican race right now. And he has built this policy, you know, the very first one we've seen from him 2 months after the announcement. He's built his first policy around that announcement speech. And unfortunately, what Trump doesn't realize, obviously not being a student of politics, not being somebody who's really astute when it comes to modern American politics, he is essentially reviving Dred Scott with his very first policy proposal to end birthright citizenship of illegal immigrants and immigrants in general. He does not want anyone born in the United States to illegal immigrants to automatically become a U.S. citizen. He thinks there's more to being an American than being born here, which is absolutely what the South tried to do during the Dred Scott era. They wanted former slaves who were not considered citizens to not have their children be citizens so that they couldn't vote. I mean, that was 100% of what it was about. They didn't want them to be able to vote. And Trump has taken us right there back to the early 1800s with his decision now.
Indeed. I mean, the 14th Amendment is what vested citizenship in many cases, like you said, to the children of slaves and former slaves. And Trump and Trump's not alone in this. But I should say this. Let me just start with this. I have to disagree with you in terms of your assessment. Trump is actually, I think, very attuned to the politics of the Republican Party. I don't think he cares a whit about policy. I don't think he cares a whit about the implications of, or I don't, let me put it this way. To the extent that he is aware that the part of the 14th Amendment he wants to repeal, that is birthright citizenship, I'm not sure that he's concerned at all that it harkens back to the Dred Scott era. He knows this is a very effective, and I want to say dog whistle, because this is a bullhorn to use with the Republican Party. And what is stunning to me, and I hope people understand, the idea is that he's arguing that undocumented immigrants or people that have, you know, entered to this country without authorization or have overstayed their visas will sometimes have a child here. That child will be considered an American citizen because they are born on U.S. soil. And he wants to end this simply because this is where the heart of the Republican Party is. And you don't have to believe me, and you don't have to believe Donald Trump. You can believe any number of the other Republican candidates who have also followed him down this road. He's not the only one who wants to repeal the 14th Amendment. Half of them do.
Well, see, look at this. It's not necessarily that Trump understands politics. I think it's more the fact that he understands Republican psychology. Because he knows, you know, basically what we're talking about right now are what Fox News and those folk call anchor babies.
Mm-hmm.
That is the term that they use. They say, oh, well, the illegal immigrants come over here, they have a child, and now we can't kick them out because the child is a U.S. citizen. And so he understands that that is very effective when you're talking to these, you know, people basically out in the Midwest, because those are the folks who are the most concerned about, you know, the talking point that immigrants are coming over here and taking our jobs. Well, those are the people who fear that their job is at risk because, you know, if you look at the statistics, they're less likely to have college education. They're more likely to work in fields that do not require any kind of specialization. And those are jobs that immigrants are able to do because employers are willing to pay them under the table wages that are far below what they'd have to pay a naturalized citizen with a Social Security number.
Right.
And but the anger in that, to me, is in the wrong place. They're angry at the politicians for letting this happen. They need to be angry at the corporations because they're the ones who want these immigrants over here. But as you just pointed out, Trump's message now is getting all these tag-alongs, all these little leeches who are coming along, Scott Walker, you know, all these folks who want to be a part of
this
Trump
momentum. Let me go quickly down. We got a minute here. Let me go down the list. Rand Paul has since has pushed for a constitutional amendment of the 14th Amendment because he didn't believe it was meant to apply to what he calls illegal aliens. Chris Christie says it needs to be reexamined. John Kasich has offered support for getting rid of birthright citizenship. Santorum, same thing back in 2012. Lindsey Graham has called for a consideration of the change in the Constitution. You've got, like you say, Scott Walker. The fact of the matter is that, and if you believe what they're saying, like, it is just simply unjust that they skipped the line, or it's unjust that they didn't take their turn. Well, how can you say that about a child who has been born here? That's just absurd. If a child's been born here, they have made no decision to come here. They have not skipped any line. They've simply been born here. It exposes the real, genuine sort of racist mentality that I think is behind this. And, you know, frankly, it's disgusting.